When it comes to improving our overall health, one thing that is often overlooked is the nervous system. We often forget how important it is to keep our nerves and neurons in great condition. Unfortunately, many of our daily habits and routines are actually causing a lot of damage to our nerves, which can lead to other health problems down the road. And this is exactly what we are going to talk about in this video, so that hopefully you can stop these bad habits and keep your nervous system in optimal condition. Be sure to watch until the end because there's actually one that I think will surprise you. So if you're ready, let's get into it. Just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for informational purposes only. The first bad habit on our list that can lead to nerve damage is something that we're all guilty of at times, and it is overeating. The reason is overeating leads to diabetes, and over half of those who are diagnosed also show signs of diabetic neuropathy as well. Studies found that peripheral neuropathy is also more common in people with high blood sugar levels, high blood pressure, and in those who are overweight. This can lead to a loss of sensation and pain and weakness in the hands and feet. If you've experienced this, then you know just how unpleasant it can be. This is why we should all try to eat a healthy and nutrient-dense diet and avoid sugar and processed foods as much as possible. It's okay to have a cheat meal from time to time, just try to do so in moderation, because overeating leads to diabetes, which ultimately can lead to nerve damage over time. Exposure to toxins is another common cause of neuropathy. Studies have linked the exposure to certain industrial chemicals and toxins in the workplace or environment to peripheral neuropathy. Some examples include mercury, lead, arsenic, and thallium. Other poisons and insecticides have been linked to nerve damage as well. This is why you should try to limit your exposure to these toxic chemicals as much as possible. The overconsumption of alcohol is another bad habit that can cause nerve damage. Alcohol has been shown to have toxic effects on nerve tissue, and overconsumption is one of the leading causes of neuropathy. The symptoms of those with alcoholic neuropathy who stop drinking may go away on their own over time. However, unfortunately, most of the nerve damage is usually permanent. Drinking too much is bad for almost all of the major organs and systems of the body. This, of course, includes the nervous system as well. Physical trauma is also one of the most common causes of nerve damage. This can stem from falls, sports injuries, or motor vehicle accidents. A bone fracture can also lead to peripheral neuropathy as well. Whenever there is an injury or increased pressure on the median nerve in the wrist, it can cause carpal tunnel syndrome, which is one of the most common types of peripheral neuropathy. Switching gears just a bit, surprisingly, not taking care of your kidneys is another bad habit that can be detrimental to the nervous system. During chronic renal failure, the kidneys can't function properly, which causes fluids and waste to accumulate in the body. Over time, this can actually lead to peripheral neuropathy. Kidney failure is often caused by diabetes and high blood pressure, which takes us back to the bad habit of overeating that we mentioned earlier in this video. Speaking of malnutrition, certain vitamin deficiencies can also cause peripheral neuropathy. Poor nutrition and eating an unbalanced diet likely means that your body isn't getting enough of the vitamins and minerals that it needs. One in particular that we should mention is vitamin B12, which is a water-soluble vitamin involved in the metabolism of every cell in the human body. Vitamin B12 deficiency is extremely common in the United States and unfortunately is linked to a number of health problems, including neuropathy. If possible, try to include foods that are high in vitamin B12 in your diet. Some examples include beef, chicken, fish, fortified breakfast cereal, eggs, and low-fat milk. Certain viruses and bacteria have also been shown to cause nerve damage. Some examples include herpes, shingles, chickenpox, West Nile virus, Lyme disease, hepatitis B and C, and HIV. Protecting your body from pathogens is one way to reduce the risk of unwanted symptoms that can come from neuropathy. This next one, unfortunately, is often unavoidable. However, certain autoimmune disorders can also cause neuropathy. Some examples include rheumatoid arthritis, lupus, Guillain-Barré syndrome, Parkinson's disease, and multiple sclerosis. Each of these disorders has a wide range of signs and symptoms, which mean that everyone may experience neuropathy differently. In fact, some who have the same condition may not experience it at all. Overuse is another common cause of neuropathy. What I mean by that is, overuse refers to making repeated motions and/or overusing a certain part of the body. This is most common in the fingers, hands, wrists, and arms. As previously mentioned, carpal tunnel syndrome is a common type of nerve damage that can be made worse by repeatedly overextending your wrist. This next one may surprise you, but certain medications have been shown to cause neuropathy. Some examples include chemotherapy drugs, anticonvulsants, antibacterial agents, and some blood pressure medications. Studies found that statins may also cause nerve damage and increase your risk of neuropathy. If you're not familiar, statins are a class of medications that are used to lower cholesterol and prevent heart disease. Thankfully, neuropathy that develops as a side effect from a medication usually goes away over time once you stop taking the drug. So just to give a quick recap, the most common bad habits that we should all strive to avoid in order to take care of our nervous system include overeating, avoiding toxins, overconsumption of alcohol, physical trauma, not taking care of our kidneys, vitamin deficiencies, viruses and bacteria, autoimmune disorders, overuse of muscles and joints, and taking certain medications. Many of these factors can not only help take better care of your nerves, but there is an overlap when it comes to improving the overall health of the remainder of your organs and body systems as well. Real quick, guys, do me a huge favor and hit the like button. It really helps support the channel and I greatly, greatly appreciate it. And while you're down there, go ahead and click the subscribe button as well, because we have a ton of other videos on our channel that I think you will enjoy. Millions of people around the world are looking for natural ways to improve their overall health. Hopefully the information that you learned in this video can help you do just that. With that said, keep in mind that we are not doctors and this video should not be taken as medical advice. Again, this video is for informational purposes only. But hopefully you learned a thing or two, and hopefully you're now one step closer to improving your overall health and thus improving the quality of your life. If so, be sure to let us know down in the comment section below. And if you want to learn even more about this topic, we do have a full guide on our website. I'll drop a link to it right below this video down in the description. Also, we have a ton of other videos on our channel that talks more about nerve damage with some other tips about how to take better care of your nervous system. I'll drop some links to some of those down below in the description as well. Thank you so much for watching all the way to the end. Have a blessed day, and as always, breathe easy, my friend.